Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to the Lobotomy Corporation Season 4. We're going to pick up right where we left off yesterday at the end of Episode 1. Thank you, everybody, for the support on Lobotomy Corporation. We have ourselves a new abnormality to pick. The Heart of Aspiration, Mirror of Adjustment, or Prophecy of the Skin. Now, I don't really have any true care about what we get here. I definitely don't want Mirror of Adjustment. Heart of Aspiration, there's nothing bad about it because it just upgrades your movement speed and attack speed. And I don't remember what Prophecy of the Skin is, so I'm just going to go for Heart of Aspiration. But yeah, we had a couple of questions. People wondering how come we're seeing the names of the abnormalities, even though like it's a brand new season. It's because everything carries over from Season 3. So what we did, we didn't do a hard reset. We did what's known as a sort of like a soft reset. So we kept all of our progression on abnormalities that we've already known. We kept the gear, of course. We just don't get the employees back, and we also don't get the gear that they died with because of just that's just how Season 3 ended. So, hello, Malkuth. And that's also the reason why you're seeing a robot here instead of an anime girl. Just so we're totally clear, and for those of you who are new subscribers and you've never seen Lobotomy Corporation before, if you're a little bit confused as to what this game actually is, again, highly recommend going back and watching Season 3 of Lobotomy Corporation. I know that seems like kind of a task to do because it is a very long season, but I mean, it's about, I think, 54 or 55 episodes, but you will see the game from back when it originally was running. This is a continuation of that season. So this is not a true new playthrough of Lobotomy Corporation because this is just a continuation. So what you're seeing is part two of a season, which ended with part one, which stopped on episode 55 or whatever. So that's the reason why it might be a little bit confusing. And I apologize about that. But again, if you are interested in learning about the game and learning everything that we've learned from the ground up, starting it with the bare bones, just a brand new save file, go watch season three and you won't be so lost. I promise you. So we have 8 lobotomy points here. I want to make sure that we get somebody to rank 5 because we're going to need the Aleph armor as fast as possible. So I'm going to keep upgrading Sinvicta. I know that might seem selfish, but we really do need someone who's rank 5 as fast as possible. So that's going to be me. And since I'm the first person here, I'm going to take charge and do that. So I can start getting Aleph stuff, even though it's not. I still can't do it yet because I don't have fortitude. But even though it's not my true set, we all know who my set is. I'm almost guaranteeing that we'll probably end up seeing nothing there. Like, almost like assuredly. So I'm going to exclusively work with Poe Day so I can get my fortitude up. Husky, and let's go with Kurt. And we're not going to work with the Heart of Aspiration just because there's no reason to. So this is known as a tool abnormality. Essentially, what they are, they're items that you pick up, and then they're bound to the person that picks up the said abnormality. They do still operate like abnormalities, as in they do still do stuff and could be bad stuff. You just don't know. You just don't know unless you've worked with them before, which I have. Just getting some help on little Poe Day. Now, we don't need to buy the gear from Poe Day. We have plenty of gear, and Poe Day is a Teth class abnormality, so its gear is not going to be that great, to be honest. I mean, we have nothing but Teths except for one bro who is a Zayn. And let's get Husky here. Let's let Rhea get a little bit of working done. Oh my god, I thought I saw him with the... No, I guess he doesn't. I could have swore I saw him with the walkie-talkie, the radio from Megahertz. I've never actually seen anyone get that before, so... And Husky got the freaking payout, too! What the heck, man? Well, let's see if Kurt can get it. I mean, One Bro's ego gift is really, really good. For starters, anyway. So, again, we're just going to be farming up points here, and, we need a core staff of really strong early heroes, early employees. Kurt can do attachment here. Again, I'm still gonna just exclusively work with Poe Day. And Husky can go get some more work there with Megahertz. This is a good setup. This is great. We have a repression slash justice farmer here. We have instinct, which is fortitude and HP, and then we also have one bro, so we can who does attachment and insight. So we can do all four of the stats that we need in the first hallway. That's really, really good. And for those of you really wanting anime girls, well, you'll have to wait until we get past the central command center. I'm sure there's plenty of places on the internet that you can look for anime girls. And one thing I will say is I do not recommend watching season 4 until you've watched season 3. Because season 4 is going to have all kinds of spoilers for Lobotomy Corporation. I probably should have said that in yesterday's episode. I do not recommend watching season 4 of Lobotomy Corporation without watching season 3 first. Because most of these story elements are not going to be a mystery. All right, so we'll go to like we'll probably go to like 8 here. I cannot overemphasize how good this is that we can work on all four stats in the first hallway. That's superb. But enjoy it now. Enjoy the good times now, because it's only going to last like this until we get to probably the next episode. Then things are going to get a little interesting. All right, Kurt, keep working that. Let's get Rhea some action here. I'm still going to be spamming Fortitude with Bode. And we'll do one more round of skill ups here, and then that'll be it. Hey, look at that. I got a perfect with Bode. All right. Attachment, we'll let Rhea get some. Let's Invicta, one more Fortitude work, and we will let Kurt finish it off. Good, this is all good. It's all good. So you see here, look how many PE boxes we have on Megahertz already. We could buy the armor if we really wanted it. I mean, there's no reason not to, I suppose, but there's also no reason to, because we don't need Megahertz. We're going to wait for Kurt to get done working with Megahertz, and then that'll be it. Good. Good job, team. Invicta, we got 5 Fortitude. We still need some more HP here. Really good gains on Husky, excellent gains on Kurt, and good gains on Rhea as well. Yeah. There you go. Again, we're just farming these early ones for stats. It's going to change soon. Day 5. The founder said this to me several times. Each successful experiment makes you a better person. Company become great after repeated failures and difficulties. So will you. Every day in the company is a step towards greatness. How was your day? Of course it was fine. Let's spare the pleasantries. Manager, how's your life been? Okay. Leading a normal life is an achievement of sort. You can always improve the quality of your life. It's a cheap something. But a tree doesn't just grow anywhere. It requires fertile soil, right temperature, and water. Most seeds end up on barren soil. By the way, the idea of trees and the theme of having trees is going to be a prevalent one throughout the entire playthrough of this game, just so you know. I can't provide you with water or light, but I will do my best to tend the soil. Thank you, Angela. All right, so we have 5 lobotomy points. I don't know where the music went. We're going to start skilling up other people as well instead of hiring a new employee, because we don't have the expanded control team layer yet. So Husky, let's get you a little bit of help in, Temperance. There we go. And we can't really equip anything else right now, so we're just going to head on over into the run. Keep it going. Now, if you're wondering what all these buttons down here do, those will come up later on in the playthrough. Essentially, those are manager powers, and what they accomplish is they allow you to have direct control over situations. So, like, I could put like a shield on somebody. I could regen their HP if I really needed them to recover if they're taking lots of damage from something. I can execute people if I need to as well. I can slow things down. This button here is the rabbit team. The rabbit team is something that you unlock in the very late game stages of Lobotomy Corporation. And we won't worry about that for now. Don't worry your pretty little head with all kinds of stuff that's just going to confuse you. Don't worry. No, it'll be fine. You don't need to worry about any of that stuff right now. All you need to know is that Lobotomy Corporation is a very complex game, somewhat. It's as complex as you want it to be. Sometimes it can be challenging, and sometimes it can be downright frustrating, but it's always a good time to come back. Gonna keep Husky in Poday's hallway here just so he doesn't have to travel a whole lot. So we'll let Husky get the fortitude swings. Again, anytime we use instinct, that's going to increase the gains of HP for a particular employee, and that's very important later on, as I'm sure you will see. So we'll go to day 8 or meltdown level 8 or something like that here. It should be fairly quick to speed things up through the process, since we have 4 employees and they're all just teeing off on different abnormalities at the start. It won't be very long for us to cycle through these, especially with Husky pretty much automatically going back into Poday's containment unit immediately. Same thing goes for Sinvicta. Get the justice work and repression done. Kurt and Rhea, you guys can stay over here. Let Rhea go. Now, if I really wanted to bore you, I could do this almost infinitely. I'm not going to do that to you all here on YouTube, though, because I respect your time and don't want you getting bored with the game. Early on, the first couple of days are like this, where you should do everything in your power to farm up as many stats as possible, because it won't be so easy later on, as you will probably undoubtedly see. Especially if you're watching this during season 4, but like if you for whatever reason decided to come back and watch the first episode again, I'm sure things have already gone sideways. Sideways of the sitting sideways variety, a la Paw Wall. Paw Wall. There's like nobody's gonna get that reference. Yeah, so we'll go down to meltdown level 6. No, Kurt, wrong one. Now, One Bro, even if you do work the wrong thing with One Bro, he still won't care. He'll still let you work and stuff. You just won't get a good result from him. But he won't. One Bro will never ever escape. Husky, there we go. Let's go for attachment with Kurt. Doesn't mean you get to hear One Bro's amazing soundtrack. I mean, who doesn't love hearing One Bro's soundtrack? We'll go to the end of this meltdown levels, which means we've got about two more work orders to do, and then we'll be done with day number 5. Season 4 of Lobotomy Corporation. We'll let Husky get the final swing on that. There we go. Kurt's almost done. Husky's almost done. We got to meltdown level 9. Not too bad there. Alright. I got some pretty good gains for justice, as you see there. Husky got a huge boost of fortitude. He did lose a little bit of prudence, however, because he wasn't keeping his mind sharp. And overall, really good gains for Kurt and for Rhea, actually. So we'll go to the next day here. Probably do one more day on this video, just like we did yesterday. Activate the Enkephalin. Fragment of the universe, Beauty and the Beast, or everything will be peaceful while you're under the fairy's care. We know this. We did not see this one in season 3, so we're going to take this one for season 4. I know what this one is, though. It's still possible that we might run into some abnormalities that I've never seen before.
Would you like to expand the information team? I'm Yassad. I still don't have a scarf on me.
Yes, Yassad. Sure everybody missed you.
I'm Yassad. We know.
All right, so imprint memory repository, that is the save. That's the save state. I'm going to put Rhea down here to work with the fairies. We've got 13 lobotomy points now. We do have a Dawn Ordeal. So ordeals are now in play. And what ordeals are, they're not random. They are random events, but you can predict when they're going to happen. It's just the result of the ordeal is random. It can be one of several different ordeals, and we don't know which one we're going to see. So we have to keep on our toes here. Let's keep improving people with the reinforcement. I'm already at EX levels of prudence. That's real good. So I will up my temperance. Kurt probably needs a little bit of upgrades here. He does. And then Rhea, we will also upgrade him. Give him fortitude. There we go. And now I think that I should be strong enough to handle Aleph stuff. And I am. Aleph gear has been taken. Alephs are the strongest type of abnormalities, also the most dangerous, not coincidentally. Okay, fairies. I don't remember what they liked or needed, but we're going to find out. Now, I do, if I recall correctly, which I do, I think the fairies have an insta-kill ability. I think. Hopefully I didn't just do it on Rhea, but we'll find out. If Rhea shows competency, yeah. I remember they are a Zane class, but they also can kill you instantly. Okay, so Rhea's got the fairy's blessing. But I think we're supposed to wait for a second before we send them back in. When the work result is normal or above, small fairies will be born around the employee. The employee's HP will be healed over time by the small fairies for a limited time. If an employee who is under the care of small fairies go to do a different management work, then the employee will immediately die and be eaten by fairies. Okay, so that's what it is. Yeah, so they cannot. So we can't do any other work while the fairy's buff is on somebody. The abnormality is similar to a fairy having two pairs of wings and a small body. They act as a cluster. They use a language that we cannot understand to communicate with each other. They follow around a few employees who enter the containment facility and use their special abilities to help heal them. Employees call this act the fairy's care. Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, good. I'll be working that. So again, we have a meltdown. We have a meltdown happening, but it's not. But none of the containment facilities are actually going to melt down, just due to us being, well, us being, we've beaten the boss fight that essentially means that we don't have to worry about meltdowns in any of these departments. There you go. So escape information. I don't remember if they actually come out or not, but their set's called Wing Beat. I hear the fairy is healing somebody. That's good. Husky. Oh, that's right. We have ordeals now. So this is the ordeal. This is the Crimson Dawn. So these little jester things, I call them Shakos from League of Legends. Essentially, what they'll do is we have to kill them before they let. What they'll do is they'll go outside of a door of one of the containment units and actually try to free the abnormalities. And you need to kill them before they can do that. They also explode whenever they die, so you have to be careful. What I like to do is I like to shield my employees with red damage, with red shields, just so when the Shakos do explode, they don't actually kill anyone. Like that. So you see that little shield there around that pawn that I don't have any control over. That is the shield, so, but good. Why do I keep seeing blue on Kurt? Every now and then I'll see him with blue on his back, and it's kind of weird. I think I'm going crazy. I think I'm actually legitimately going crazy. Again, we'll go to day 8 here. And by day 8, I mean meltdown level 8. Rhea's getting healed by the fairies. I like that. Hopefully he gets the fairies' blessing that'll be neat. There we go. So the fairy festival. Look at them. They're just all happy. The fairies protect our employees. That is, if you often acted out of the goodness of your heart, our lover of nature, and are a competent being, then the fairies will gladly take care of you. Everything will be peaceful while you're under the fairies' care. Also, you can enjoy the envy of other employees. Not that this is important, but... And if the fairies don't approach you, then you should reflect on your life. When Emil and I took shifts entering the fairies' containment facilities, the fairies did not hesitate to approach me. Just me, and never Emil. You all know Emil and how he is. Why, even yesterday, he refused to share his snacks with me and was acting all high and mighty. It is sacred to be protected by the fairies in any world, but don't enter the containment facility just for fun. If you've read some books, you will know that the fairies don't like people who take advantage of their kindness. The corresponding documents only allowed to be seen by employee levels with 4 or above, which is me. When Walter, who was under the care of the fairies, died in the containment facility of another abnormality, we found some anomalies. His stomach and face were ripped off, and his eyeballs and organs were eaten by something. Moreover, the containment facility that Walter was found in was for the abnormalities that used mental attacks. Fairies that were discovered in a different area had someone's blood and flesh smeared all over their mouths. We did not perform a test to find out whose flesh and blood it was. In our world, there are few results that are done due to perfect kindness. Having fairies that live in forests visit you just because they like you, or you do many good deeds, it is just something that happens only in fairy tales. Fairy tales. Even though we know this is the truth, we sometimes become deluded. That the fairies' care is happening because all the good deeds I've done in my life, or that the fairies are favoring me because there's something that makes me more special than the other employees. However, fairies are just monsters who like meat. They protected you because they wanted to keep their food fresh. When the employee starts working in a different containment facility, they gobble the employee up in fear that they are going to lose their food to something else. But most of the employees who received care from the fairies were greatly satisfied. Although the accident rate greatly reduced while the fairies were given care and is a positive effect for the company, therefore it has been decided that the employees will not be told the full truth. And that is Lobotomy Corporation in a nutshell. But with us being a manager, we actually rise above the classification levels of level 4, so we get to know that. And now you all too. Just don't tell the employees. Just don't tell Husky. Getting some real good gains here. Go for attachment work. Now, since we're done with the Ordeal of Dawn, we don't have to worry about it coming back for today. But just know that there are other ordeals that will show up eventually. And they become increasingly more disruptive, is the best way I can say that. And that's putting it mildly. When we start actually fighting literal gods in the game, that's when we can start worrying about, you know, the true ordeals. This is a very unique situation though, where we can work all 4 stats at once, and for different employees, so we can shuffle people around as well. The longer that you keep employees in the same department, the better that their bonuses are. But with this being so early on in the playthrough, it doesn't really matter that much. We can move employees around as we see fit. So we'll go up to level 8, I think, is a good place to stop. And again, I reiterate, if I really wanted to min-max this, I would keep going. I wouldn't just stop at 8, I would just go infinitely. Okay, maybe not infinitely, but you know what I mean. I would go a lot longer, but again, I don't want to bore y'all with that. But giving you all the reasons why I'm doing stuff is something that I will be doing in Season 4. However, again, I do strongly recommend watching Season 3. All the way through. If not all the way through, then definitely the first couple of episodes so you can see what the game is about. Hello, one bro. Good to see you. We'll go one more round for everybody, and then that'll be it. So whenever Kurt is done, that's when we'll call it. But good gains. Good gains all around. I'm liking the setup. It's a good setup here. All right, Husky and Kurt are both now rank 5. Civicta got huge justice gains here. Big gains for Temperance, as to be expected from Husky. He also worked Prudence a little bit because he was working with one bro. Kurt got huge fortitude buffs. The same thing goes for Rhea, actually, now 80. So Husky is now the weakest one as far as HP is concerned. So Husky needs to work either with Poday or the fairies for tomorrow. So But yeah, that'd do it for episode 2 of Lobotomy Corporation season 4. Thank you all very much. As a quick preview of who we've got coming up, Shylock Bald is awesome, and who is this? Somewhere this is here, Seagulls. Ah, we have also not seen them since season 1. Again, I do know most of the abnormalities in the game. It's just from me playing through. This is the fourth time now I played through the game. There are still abnormalities I've never seen before. Will we see them this season? Will we not? Find out next time on Lobotomy Corporation season 4. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.